We all have been there. You're chatting with someone, hey, how are you? And you're getting these minutes long voice messages. Basically, they're off putting the workload on you. It's easy to ramble around to make a long message, but you have to hear it and extract the important information for yourself instead of them putting their thoughts in a concise message. It's okay if it happens sometimes, but if it keeps occurring, it's annoying. So what if you could build a Langchain voice transcriber that summarizes the message? So you don't have to sit there all the time and listen to all those messages but still get the information. If you're interested how we're going to build this with Langchain and a Telegram bot, then keep watching. Hello, my name is Leon and welcome to my channel. Today I want to tackle this problem of annoyingly long voice messages, or maybe you just want to learn how to use speech to text within Langchain. Here is the voice message of my introduction and here's the summary. This is what you're going to learn today. We'll code everything and I will also provide you with the GitHub link so you can clone the repository and don't have to do everything yourself. Okay, before we start building the bot, we want to talk about the data flow, the concept of it all. So we want to receive the audio files. We have the Telegram bot who's checking the whole time for updates. If you're sending a new message, in this case, a voicemail or an audio file. And after that, we have to load it because we can't stream the message. We have to store it as a file. And therefore, we need to build a loader which loads the file and also transcribes it. Therefore, we are going to use the Whisper API from OpenAI. At the next stage, we have to decide how are we going to summarize it. And this is going to depend if it's a short audio file or a long audio file. Or in other words, if the transcription is longer than the context window of the model. We're working with GPT 3.5 Turbo. The context window is something bit more than 4,000. Therefore, if the file is longer than 4,000, we have to build a chain that accounts for that. And we're going to use the MapReduce chain. I have a whole video on that that covers the different methods. For now, you just have to know we're going to use it if it's too long. At the next stage, pipe it into GPT 3.5 Turbo to create a summary with as much information as possible so we have everything covered. And at the last stage, send the summarized text to the user. Okay, now you know the concept, what we have to do in general. Are you ready? Let's jump over in VS Code and start coding. Okay, now we're in VS Code. Let's start by creating a virtual environment. We just write 53-m wenf and then give it a name, telegram audio wenf. So as we go with an environment, we can source it. And now we can install our requirements. So what we need: Python Telegram bot, python.env, Langchain, OpenAI, and PyDub. That's it for this tutorial. Okay, let us create the audio summarizer class. So audio summarizer.py. We will need a couple of imports here. You can pause the video if you want and take a closer look. I'll just go along in the video and you will see how we integrate those parts in the actual code. So let's create the class audio summarizer and the initialize function. Let's first think about what methods are going to need. How is this class working at the end? So we want a function to create a large language model. We want a function to create the parser or the transcriber, which will be the Whisper API. We want a loader to load the file. We want to create a prompt, obviously. And we need the LLM chain, also the MapReduce chain. We also need the summarize function itself. Let us start with the create LLM. Since we're working with OpenAI, we can just return OpenAI and set temperature to 0. Since we don't want the model to make up something or be creative, it should just summarize the input it gets. For the parser, we will use on Langchain the OpenAI Whisper parser. This is an interface that basically just uses the OpenAI API to parse the documents. And here the create loader. So if you take a look at the Langchain API, you see there are a lot of different loaders, but there's not a specific one for our case where we need to load the audio file and transcribe it with the Whisper API. So therefore, we're just going to take the generic loader. There we can define a way to load the document and also use a specific parser we defined. We just want to load from file system, give it the path, the pattern it should look at, and all the file endings it should take into consideration. What we're going to do here, let's just copy it over and make adjustments. Return it directly. So the path, yeah, we will just get the path from the parameters here, the glob pattern as well, and we are working with audio files, specifically with OGG files. Okay, yeah, that would already be it. And what I forget, we have the parser argument here. We are just going to use self.parser, and for that, let's define self.parser equals self.createParser. We want to create the prompt. I have it already defined. For that, we want to return the prompt template, take the input variable text, and write the template something like that. you can refine it if you want. What I like to do, if possible, make a bullet point summary. Next, we need the LM chain. Therefore, we want to return the LM chain, and the LM model will be self.llm. And for that, we can go up here again and create self.llm equals self create LM. Then the prompt will be self.prompt. Now let's say LM chain prompt again, create self.llm chain prompt self. And at last, let's set verbose to true so we can always see what's happening. Okay, that's easy. Now we have the LM chain. Now the little bit more complicated part, the map chain, that you would return the load summarized chain, the parameters it needs. It also needs the LM, which will be the same LM as above. We need to define the chain type, which will be in this case MapReduce. What MapReduce does, it just gets multiple input files, summarizes each file by itself, and then makes a summary or condenses all those summaries together into one output. With that, we can work with larger files or documents and create summaries of the whole, which would usually not pass into the context size of the model. We also want to set verbose to true. And here we have two prompts. We have the map prompt and the combine prompt. And we need to define those right now. We will make it within this function. So the map, actually, if I think about it, let's make this function reusable. So get, let's define the LM chain prompt within this function itself, will be self.create prompt. And as input parameters, we also want to give it the input variables and a template. Then we just take it over here and okay, so let's template and input variables, and with that, let's remove it from here. Okay, now we can define the prompt here also by calling self.createPrompt. The input variable will also be the text and the template. Here's what I came up with: this following text as part of a transcribed voice or audio file. Write a summary and contain as much information as possible. So here we have the map prompt. Let's define the combine prompt. Combine prompt equals also, again, we can call this function now. Same input variables, template. Write a summary of the following text, which consists of summaries of parts of voice message. Summarize in the same language. And again, keep as much information as possible. So easily like that. Now we can add the combine prompt here, and this would be our load summarized chain. Let's go to the initialized function again and create everything we need. So we need the loader, self.loader equals self.createLoader. Okay, and the path, loader path, and the glob pattern we will get from here. The loader path on default is going to be the TMP folder, because we don't want to store the audio and voice files persistently. We just want to store it temporarily, and therefore we're going to start in the TMP folder. Glob pattern means we will just look for everything within the folder that has this pattern, and we will take every name that ends with OGG. So it can be some arbitrary name as long as it ends with OGG. Then we have our loader. We need to get self LM chain, create LM chain, and the map chain. Okay, within the summarize function, we have to decide which chain are we going to use, the LM chain or the map chain. And therefore, we have to split up our text if it's too large. So we want to also use text splitter here. If we go over to Langchain, we can use the recursive character text splitter. It inherits from text splitter itself, and text splitter itself has as length measuring function the len function, and len operates on characters, not tokens. Therefore, we need to take that into account. So what we want to think about here is we have this prompt, which will enter the LLM chain. This prompt plus the text should be smaller than the context window. The context window should be 4096. Therefore, we can go to OpenAI tokenizer and enter our prompt template, which you can see. Okay, our prompt template are roughly, let's say, 80 tokens. So we can take 4000 tokens as chunk size, but with the recursive character text splitter, we have to calculate how much characters, which will be here. You can see 4 characters roughly estimate to 1 token. So we have to multiply the 4000 tokens with 4, which should be 16,000. So we can define our recursive character text splitter, you want to import it as well here. Self.text splitter equals self dot underscore create text splitter, and chunk size here is going to be, okay, let's make it this way, token chunk size. We will define the token chunk size of 4000, and within the function, to reduce the confusion, we will make the conversion, and then the chunk size will be the token chunk size multiplied by 4, and this should be it. Okay, now I want to define our summarize function. For that, we are going to transcribed document equals self loader.load. So usually if you take a loader from Langchain, it has the load and split function. But if we take a closer look in the generic loader at the Langchain repository in the code itself, we can see that loading and splitting is not implemented for generic loaders. So we can only load it, and then we have to do the splitting ourselves. Therefore, that's why we needed a splitter. Okay, now we can return the documents as self.text splitter.create documents from the transcribed documents. And now we want to make the if-else case. If the length of the documents is greater than 1, then we need a map reduce chain. Summary equals self map reduce chain dot run and input the documents with input documents equals documents. Else we the summary will be the LM chain dot run and text equals documents 0. Because there will be only one document in it, obviously, and we take the page content. Okay, and then we want to just return the summary. A small correction here, the function create documents gets as input a list of texts, but we already have a list of documents, therefore we need to call the function transform documents. Okay, and now it should work. Okay, now we got our audio summarizer ready. Now we will code our Telegram chatbot and integrate everything. I hope you could learn something to this point, how to work with speech to text, use the Whisper API, use the generic loader. So let's head over now. Okay, in Telegram first we have to go to the bot father. Gives the impression of Al Pacino, that's fine. Okay, we click on new bot. How are we going to call it? Voice to text summary bot. Okay, here we get our token. That token we're going to put in our .env file, and also we can just click here, and there we have our voice summary bot. In the .env file, add the token here. You can head over to the Python Telegram bot repository, and there's everything explained how to work with it. You can check the Telegram API, and there you will see all possible functions and everything you can do with it. So I'm just going to code everything up here and explain a little bit along the way. Here again, some imports we're going to need. Also, another thing you want to do, you can go to Telegram to the user info bot and get your user ID. You don't want every user to just interact with it for free. Therefore, just whitelisting ourselves, just put it in the env file under user ID, and then you will see how we'll do that. Okay, at first we want to create our audio summarizer. We want to create some basic login functionality. Okay, we want to define if name equals main, and here we want to open an application builder, define dot token, which will be Telegram bot token dot build. That's how we build our application. So how does it work? We need to add handlers. For example, we want a start handler, which will be a command handler, and there are also message handlers, and yeah, the command will just be start. Then we need to define a start function using definition, and this is how functions are going to look within the Telegram bot. You get the update and the context. The update contains the message or the audio file, whatever the user gave us, and with the context we can let the bot answer by send a message, and here in this case I am bot, please talk to me. We have created the handler, now we need to add a handler. So in this case, application add handler, start handler, and with that we can create application dot run polling. Now we could already start the bot, and well, we could use the work of the command start. So try it out, Python 3 Telegram bot. Okay, now the application is running. Let's open up Telegram. Now we can have the start command, and now we are conversing with the bot. Okay, let's go for the voice handler. It's going to be message handler. We want to get filters dot voice, and we want to exclude everything that is a command, and then we want the function handle voice message, then add the handler again here, voice handler. Okay, how we're going to define the function, what we're going to do here first, we're going to check updates not effective chat ID equals os dot get env from user ID. So we defined in the NV file our user ID and we're checking if it is us who is sending this message. And if that's the case, what we need to do here now, we want to get the file, which will be await update message.voice.getfile. And we need to define another function, handle file, which will get the file, the update and the context. Okay, let us define this new function, async definition, handle file, again, file update context. Okay, what we need to do here with, again, we can stream the audio directly to the parser. We have to store it as a file before and we don't want to store it and remove it. So we're just storing it as a temporary file. And that's possible with the Python temp file library. And here's how it's going to look. We've named temporary file and we want to give it the suffix OGG as temp file. We want to await. So this is the Telegram file which we're downloading to the drive to temp file.name. So this will be our directory where we store it. And since it's a temp file, it's going to store it in /tmp and then after it some number and letter combination .ogg, since that's our suffix. And now we can just create a summary audio summarizer .summarize. And if we look again at our summarizer function, it's going to load documents with the loader, and the loader will look in the file system at the path we defined, which is going to be tmp, at the glob pattern, so any letter number combination with OGG endings, and then it's going to load these files. Here again, it's going to be one at a time, and then parses them with our Whisper API, and then at the end returns a summary. So here we'll have the summarized text. Now we can send it, await context bot send message, chat ID equals update effective chat ID back to us, and the text is going to be the summary.
Okay.
And now, why did we create the handle file function? Because we can do the same with the audio message. So you can either have a voice message directly created in Telegram, or you can send also messages from WhatsApp over audio messages, but these will be audio files and not Telegram voice messages. And therefore, we need to create this function as well, handle audio message, and basically just do the same here, but instead of voice, it's going to be audio and handle audio message. And we also want to add the handler, add audio handler. Okay, little jump forward. I added the function check user ID. So we will check the ID. If it matches, then we will return true, else false. And what I have done in the audio summarizer, I return a dictionary which contains the summary and also the full transcribed text. So we can decide if we want to read the summary or just the text. Therefore, in the handle file, we will send at first the full text from the output dictionary and the summary after that. Okay, so let's actually test it. Telegram bot.py. Okay, I'm recording a message now. This is a test. Okay, I hope you like this video so far. We have built everything up. Now we are at the last step. We're testing it and I'm very excited to see what the results are. So let's see. So it's transcribing it. We have entering the chain. There's the actual text. Perfect. The summary. This video is about the last step of a project, which is testing. The speaker is excited to see the results of the text. Perfect. We have the full transcribed text to see if it matches and the summary. I like it. So thank you for watching. I think this was a very interesting project. I hope you could take something with you, especially the generic loader part, how we transcribed it with the Whisper AI, how we used this as a parser and wrapped everything here in a chatbot. Thank you for watching. Click the like button, click the subscribe button, and see you in the next video.